CompTIA ITF Plus Complete Training Course. Exam Objective 2.8, given a scenario, install, configure and secure a basic wireless network. Encrypted versus unencrypted. When configuring a wireless network device, you will be presented with a very important security option. Do you want to encrypt your wireless network? Now, before you jump right in and say, "Of course I want to encrypt," I will cover a few cases where you might want to leave your wireless network unencrypted. Leaving your wireless network unencrypted or having what is called open authentication allows unrestricted access to the network without requiring a password or authentication credentials. This can be useful in public spaces or guest environments to offer convenient and seamless internet access to a wide range of users. A perfect example would be a popular coffee shop in the heart of the city. With an open authentication wireless network in place, customers can easily connect to the internet without the need for a password or any authentication process. This makes it hassle-free for patrons to use their laptops, smartphones, or tablets. In doing so, users do need to be aware that they are responsible for their own data security while using the open network. Using an unencrypted wireless network is risky due to lack of password security protocols. Without encryption, information on the network can be seen by others. So try not to log into your bank account while connected to one of these networks. Paired with open authentication, you will often come across captive portals, and keeping in step with our coffee shop scenario. On the right, we have a captive portal from my local Starbucks. Captive portals are commonly used with open authentication networks to provide an additional layer of control when sharing a wireless network with strangers. Even though we may not be requiring a password to authenticate, we may still want a user to at least agree to some terms and conditions of use. Some additional reasons for a captive portal may include informing a user of data collection or to provide management of a user's session. Captive portals are typically displayed as web pages that appear automatically when a user connects to an open network or attempts to access the internet for the first time after connecting. These web pages are designed to capture the user's attention and require them to take specific actions before gaining full access to the network. Now that we have covered the unencrypted option, let's switch over to encrypted networks. We will be covering four key encryption standards: WEP, WPA, WPA2, and WPA3. And if you looked at the CompTIA ITF Plus exam objectives, you might have noticed I have added WPA3 to the list. This may not be a part of the current ITF Plus exam as it is a newer standard, but it has found its way into the exams of many other IT certifications, so I figured, why not cover it in this video? Now, as I briefly work my way through these four wireless encryption standards, use the table behind me to keep yourself organized. I will start at the top and work my way down. First up, we have WEP, or Wired Equivalent Privacy. This is the oldest and weakest of the encryption standards. WEP used an RC4 encryption mechanism, which had some serious security flaws and could be easily cracked by determined hackers. So, it's best to avoid using WEP and opt for a more secure option. Next, we have WPA, or Wi-Fi Protected Access. WPA was an improvement over WEP and offered better security. It used a more robust encryption mechanism known as TKIP. This made it a bit harder for attackers to break into your network. However, like WEP, WPA is also considered outdated and not the best choice for modern Wi-Fi security. Moving on to WPA2, or Wi-Fi Protected Access 2. This is a more modern standard for securing Wi-Fi networks and has been widely used for years. WPA2 uses a stronger encryption mechanism known as AES. AES is highly secure and much more difficult for attackers to crack. If you have a relatively new router, it will likely support WPA2, and this is the best and most secure standard of those listed in the CompTIA ITF Plus exam objectives. And now for the bonus encryption standard, WPA3. WPA3 is the latest and most advanced wireless encryption standard. WPA3 builds on the strengths of WPA2 and adds even more security features, such as the SAE encryption mechanism. WPA3 is currently the gold standard for Wi-Fi security, and if your wireless network device supports it, it is the best choice for keeping your network safe. One last note about these encryption standards. Just because your wireless network device supports a specific encryption standard does not mean the wireless clients do. It is very common that an older wireless client, such as a laptop, smartphone, or even a wireless IoT device like an oven, refrigerator, or light switch, may not support some of the newer encryption standards. If this happens, the client may not be able to connect to the network. Just some food for thought. Thank you for watching. Subscribe for more great content.